Maestro Zerda, the Rossini operas are nowadays in every opera house in the world and become part of the major repertoire. Do you think that this is also thanks to the Rossini Opera Festival and to the academy that you direct, have been directing for the past 27 years?
Yes, of course. It's also partially a merit of the festival, but not only. This was the moment for Rossini. It was already late. And sorry to say this, but not enough. Not enough, yet not enough. Rossini merits. He's a great composer, such incredible creator that I think he will be more and more present. I hope at least.
In order to sing Rossini well, we know that not only technique and vocal capabilities are needed. What else does a singer need?
Well, you need the fantasy, the capacity to transform the musical items of Rossini that are short, not so beautiful sometimes, more inexpressive in itself, more abstract, to transform all this in real feelings, in emotions, in expressivity, not the generic expressivity, but the expressivity that you need for the theatrical situation, for the personage you are. Rossini used the same music for comic, for instance, and dramatic music. Just this gives you the idea what changes, what makes different the musical subject to the drums is the creativity of the artist. The music is the same. If you read it the first time and you don't know the text, you cannot decide if this is music for a comic opera or for a dramatic. But the interpretation, when you sing this, and for this, the singers, the Rossini singers, are not normal singers. Just from the time of Rossini, they were considered divi, they were called like divinity, because they have this capacity to create something. So I mean, Rossini needs his interpreters, you know. Some composers are so expressive in themselves, the music is so accomplished that you need a beautiful voice, a technique, intelligence, but you need particularly a creative participation that arrives also to include your intervention as a composer. I mean, you can change through the variazioni, variations, cadenzas, puntature. You have a certain freedom to change the text in a limit, very close limit. But insomma, he's a collaborator, he's not only an interpreter.
In the musical world, Maestro, you are considered almost like Rossini's alter ego. You give us his message. So, what we would like to know, do you have a favorite opera of Rossini or a favorite character?
Well, it's a little difficult because you see that Rossini is so rich, there are so many themes, so many, he's one of the richest composers. But personally, I like particularly Semiramide because it's not only a beautiful opera, a big opera, but is the more Rossinian, I mean the more specific. If I have to indicate an opera, then maybe I can also like other music more in the context. But Semiramide is for me just the Rossini. His characteristics, I like, besides this, is a beautiful opera.
Yes.
And the short one is the longest, but when you listen or conduct Semiramide, it's really a short opera. And I am going to conduct this in a couple of weeks at my age. My wife says that it's impossible. It's possible because it's Semiramide. Another opera will not be possible.
Next year, Maestro, after many years, you are no longer going to be the artistic director of the Rossini Opera Festival, but you will still be directing the Accademia.
Not only I will follow to work with the Accademia, but I also hope to improve my participation in the Accademia, I mean, to give more time to the teaching. For me, this is the most important task, especially for a man of my age and of my experience. The only advantage to become old is to get more and more experience, and you can transfer this to young people, and this is the only important thing that we can leave to our
young students,
to our new youth, or something like.
Would you like to salute our American Rossini fans from the Friends of the Rock?
First of all, to thank them, and I was hoping in many years finally to get a presence of Rossini also in the United States, that you know, how important us also from a musical point of view. And finally we have these friends, and so enthusiastic, so generous, so it's so rich, and so, I mean, they really understand it's not, come dire, you know, for a composer, it's for this kind of composer. I mean, on is not an opera and the man, is a, come si può dire, I think that will be also for them the same discovery that was for us. And in the last years, or centuries, I agree. I think this is probably the most great, important discovery in the musical field. So thanks again, and let's see to have more and more presence every year. We expect here in Pesaro, and we hope one day to have also a Rossini Festival in the United States. And that will be the final point. We will realize the point where we can say, oh, we finally reached our target for us and for Rossini.